now. Channel 5, Eyewitness News at Noon.
If you suffer from massive anxiety at the thought of a trip to the dentist's office, join the crowd. You have lots of company. But what about that poor dentist? Our guest today is Dr. Susan Carabin, an assistant clinical professor in periodontics at Columbia University, as well as consultant to Listerine. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
How did dentists get this reputation?
Well, I think it dates back to ancient history when blacksmiths were dentists, and we didn't have anesthesia, and we used very archaic instruments to treat teeth.
You know, as patients, I don't think we ever think about it, but doesn't it make you feel bad ever as a dentist to have everybody look at you with a look of horror and fear?
Well, I think it takes a lot of patience and a good, strong ego to be able to treat people like that, yes.
You've brought along some interesting-looking tools here that we've been calling tools of torture all morning. Shall we start over here, maybe, and you can tell
okay.
us what we're looking at?
This is a syringe, a hypodermic needle. This one actually was used for irrigating wounds. It's made of silver, and the plunger is actually leather, so it wasn't able to be sterilized. This was before the techniques of sterilization. But this was used to wash out wounds, or a smaller needle was used to give an injection of anesthesia.
And these frightening-looking utensils next to it?
This is a particularly vicious-looking instrument. This was for extracting teeth. It was called a dental key. It was actually used like a corkscrew to hook around the tooth and to rip the tooth out, bone and all.
And then there are a couple of brushes next
okay.
to that.
Okay, these brushes are actually from the mid-1800s. They're made of an early form of plastic called Bakelite. But before that, they were made of ivory or wood. They, again, were not able to be sterilized. And you got these from your dentist. We all think that the modern toothbrushes with the swiveling heads or the fancy toothbrushes are new. These were around for a long time.
Speaking of toothbrushes, tell us the difference between plaque and tartar, and which do we need to worry about the most?
Right. Plaque is that film that forms on your teeth continuously. You know, when you wake up in the morning, there's sort of a film. Those are actually bacteria, and that is plaque. Those bacteria continuously form, and if you allow them to stay on your teeth for more than 24 hours, it hardens into tartar, or calculus. And that calculus is actually made up of dead bacteria and calcium salts from your saliva.
Now, we're almost out of time, but I think we should touch on gum disease, since
right.
it has been said that 90% of us will get it.
Right.
What can we do to prevent it?
Well, what really is the basis of good oral hygiene is brushing, flossing, and using a good antiseptic mouthwash such as Listerine. By the way, Listerine has just gotten the ADA seal of acceptance against plaque and gingivitis, so that's the one I recommend.
What about water picks?
Water picks are wonderful, but they don't remove plaque. They're good for removing large particles of food.
So that's why you have to do it in conjunction with the flossing and the brushing.
Right, exactly.
Dr. Carabin, thank you very much for joining us today. We
My
appreciate
pleasure.
It. We'll take a break here. We'll be back in just a moment with Janice Huff and the weather, and she'll tell us if we'll be facing a wet weekend. Stay with us.
Indiana. We're going to talk a little bit about dentistry. Times have changed for the dental profession. Unfortunately, not enough people know that, and that's what we're going to talk about right now. Dr. Susan Carabin is a dentist in New York City, and she visits us to tell us a little bit about the history of dentistry. And people still have dental phobias. Why don't they, has that changed at all?
Well, it has changed, but there are 35 million people who have some dental anxiety when they go to the dentist's yeah. office. And there are some 12 million dental phobics in this country who don't go to dentists at all.
And they are afraid of the very things which I suppose have already changed. Is that
Absolutely,
correct?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, no, the phobias and the anxiety have been passed on generation to generation, mm-hmm. and a lot of this dates back to the 17th and 18th century when dentistry was done by blacksmiths or barbers, and there wasn't any dental anesthesia, and there weren't all the fancy new equipment that we have today.
That hurts just to say that. I read in some of the material that you sent that George Washington did not have a wooden tooth.
No, actually, they were human teeth and ivory, and it was a combination of silver and...
But he didn't have very many, did he?
No, he only had one when he became president.
Oh, that's a shame. We don't know how many Reagan has of his own. No one's ever told us. It is his own hair. This is kind of a look back to dental history, and this first item right here goes back real far. Tell us about that.
That's called a dental key,
and it was used for extracting teeth. That is from the late 1700s to the early 1800s.
Gosh.
It's actually used like a corkscrew.
Ooh.
It was hooked. This is why people have fears. It's some of these instruments. This was hooked under the tooth, and it was actually cranked out, and the bone broke, and the tooth came out, and it, you know, wasn't really a lot of finesse involved.
Okay, fine. Did I have a name?
Dental key.
Dental key. All right.
All right.
Now, how about the, are these three together for a reason?
Yes. Yeah. Well, the first two were early dental drills. This was before they had mechanical drills. Mm-hmm. The foot pedal drill was the first one. These are from the early 1800s. The first one was used to just start the hole by mm-hmm. twirling that instrument, and the second one was for enlarging the hole. Mm-hmm. Only the soft decay was removed. They didn't believe in removing good, quote, tooth structure, but actually we know now that some of that tooth structure needs to be removed to put a good filling in.
So the concept of filling a cavity is
right.
How old about?
Oh, it goes back to the ancient Egyptians.
Does it really?
Really, yes.
Yeah, what'd they fill it with?
Gold.
They did fill it with
yes.
gold.
Yes.
And we didn't improve on that until really recently, did
That's
we?
That's right.
All righty,
right.
The next one looks like...
It's a very
like,
good filling material.
Looks like my toothbrush, as a matter of fact.
Well, no, there's one more tool there
oh,
that
I'm
I'd
sorry.
Like to talk about, which is the one on the end. Yes,
sorry.
That's... A pulp tester. That's to tell whether the tooth is alive or dead. And there's a nerve inside the tooth that sometimes dies, and we need root canal.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we have electronic and electrical testers now that send a little electrical current through the tooth, and you can mm-hmm. tell whether it's alive or dead. Well, this one was used for that purpose, but it was heated up till it was flaming red and then mm-hmm. put against your tooth. And if you said, ow, that meant the tooth was alive.
Well, you actually heated it up.
Right.
This would also test whether it was alive or dead, because if you screamed,
right.
you knew it was alive. All right. An old toothbrush, I would
yes.
guess.
These are some fancy toothbrush. You know now there are all these fancy mm-hmm. angled toothbrushes that are out on the market that seem to be very innovative. They've been around for a long time. This first toothbrush has a head that actually swivels. You can put it in different positions. This one is made of Bakelite, which is an early plastic, but most of them were made of ivory or wood and could not be sterilized. And you couldn't buy these. You would get them from your
it
dentist.
Swivels.
Yes, it swivels. The
now we use a stationary
swivels.
Brush and your head swivels.
Right.
So it did the same thing.
And the other one is for just brushing the inside of your teeth. It's angled in that way so that you could just brush the inside.
Is that very old? Do they still have those?
No, we don't use anything quite like that now. But, you know, there are all kinds of different shapes of toothbrushes, but they date back for a long time. These are from the early 1800s.
That's fascinating. And the last one?
The last one is called a goat's foot elevator because of its resembling a goat's foot.
Mm-hmm.
We do have instruments that are very similar to that now, but this one was kind of cute because it was called a goat's foot. It's for extracting teeth. It's for elevating the tooth out of the socket.
You know, you put Vaseline on a goat's foot. Did you
right.
know that when it goes out? For... Is that an early syringe?
That's an early syringe. Actually, this is an irrigating syringe for washing out wounds. You'll notice that the needles are quite thick. You
mm-hmm.
wouldn't want to be injected with one of these, but it is made of leather. The plunger is leather and the outside is silver, and this could not be sterilized. You know,
mm-hmm.
this was pre-sterilization. You
How
know.
Old is the idea of Novocaine or something similar to Novocaine?
Novocaine was first used, I believe, in the 1840s.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. It's been around for a long time.
Yeah. Now, you're traveling for Listerine, we should
That's
say,
right.
and do you want to put in a good plug for healthy teeth?
Well, yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Part of the news is that the American Dental Association has just given its seal of acceptance to Listerine
mm-hmm.
as an anti-plaque and gingivitis
mm-hmm.
mouthwash. Okay, it's very important if you'd like to talk about plaque and
well,
gingivitis.
Well, in the 2 seconds we have left, what is the difference between tartar and plaque?
Okay.
I don't know that myself.
Okay. Plaque is the invisible film of bacterial colonies that continuously forms on your teeth, okay? That's what you wake up in the morning, your mouth feels kind of fuzzy. That's
yeah.
plaque. Those
mm-hmm.
are live bacteria. Calculus is the calcified bacteria that gets left on your teeth when you miss some when you're mm-hmm. brushing. And that calculus becomes calcified by the salts in your saliva.
Mm-hmm.
It's primarily a cosmetic problem, but it builds up
mm-hmm.
and your dentist then has to remove it.
And what's the tartar?
Tartar is calculus.
Is calculus.
Yes, they're
okay.
two names for the same
I was
thing.
Never very good at calculus, and I guess I'm still not. All right. And once again, Listerine seems to be an effective, I can't say that big word, but...
antiseptic mouthwash, yes, it is. In addition to seeing your dentist, brushing, flossing, if you use Listerine, you will get that much more added effect.
Okay, and if you see one of these in your dentist's office...
Run.
Get the yellow pages. Doctor, thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll take a break. We'll do some Caribbean cooking.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Season's greetings.